Hello, good people of the internet. Sinashi and Lulu here.
Hi!
We are going to go to World 2 for a moment. Before we fight the final boss battle, because we are going to prepare. And by prepare, I mean we're gonna, you know, shoot his ass full of lasers. Also, I believe there was a question I saw in a video of what laser stands for. There we go. That's what it stands for. Light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation.
And it ricochets off hills, too. Woo-hoo.
Yep. When I was a kid, I did not know that laser was a, was it anagram, I believe it is, or...
acronym. Anagram, I think, is like the olive, and it's an anagram of I love.
Oh. He's gonna try to inhale us, but unfortunately, he's just gonna get lasered. Oh god. And the funny thing is, each time you hit him, it stops. Oh no! Oh shit. I was careless! Oh god! No! Stop! This is Kirby's finest hour right here. Oh, well, I guess not. Okay, there we go. King DDD has been defeated. Let's go return the Star Rod to the Fountain of Dreams. Oh, what's going on here? He's saying no, because he wants his bath. He's desperate to keep his bath. Oh no, why, Kirby? Huh, what is this? Oh no! It's a bubble! Let's all panic. Except for King DDD. He knows exactly what needs to be done. Alright. This is just kind of it. I mean, nothing really witty to say here. Just hitting a star at some bubbles.
At a starry bubble.
It is a very starry bubble, although I will note that we are slowly going towards the ground right now. And that we actually can be killed via squishing if we linger around. I don't want to at least get the ground to appear. See, there's some trees. Gonna wait for the ground to appear. There it is. Okay. And you see, it'll just slowly drag us towards the top of the screen. Where we will die if we linger. This is where we confront the ultimate nightmare. Oh no, our warp star. Nope, no high speed chase this time. Instead we get this guy.
He reminds me of a dreidel with a warp headpiece.
A dreidel with what?
With a horrible headpiece.
Oh, yeah. He's very, blingalicious. And this was, the main villain of the anime, actually. Because this is the, dude who kept selling all those monsters to King DDD. He loves to just kind of teleport and then, you know, do that. Whoops! Okay, let's try this again. So yeah, now we have the full power of the Star Rod to jump and, you know, do this. Ow, never mind, that was not as ninja as I thought it was gonna be. And we can collide into him with the tip of the Star Rod by spinning, or we can just launch a star at him and do much more damage. He's pretty well this attack pattern. I'm surprised he hasn't used it. There we go. That's the move I was waiting for him to use. Nothing really exciting to do here. I mean, except to marvel in that awesome background that's just constantly going by us. I have no idea what that move does. I've never actually been hit by it. Ah, damn it. I did not get behind him in time. Oh, God! Forgot he did that. The fight doesn't usually last this long. There. That's it. That's the final boss. Whee! And we completed it! Yay! So what we get for completing it normal is extra mode, which we have 3 less HP. Now, completing no extra on 100% though gets you a thing that we're going to do in a bonus video. And now it's just kind of giving us the epilogue. King DDD did not mean any harm, despite the fact that he, you know, broke the Star Rod and then was bathing in the Fountain of Dreams. You know, he's just bathing in there. It's a pretty simple story, you know?
Pretty complex at the time, with everything, so...
That's true. But nothing like, Final Fantasy or anything. Then again, Final Fantasy story was weird. Like, the first one was... First one was pretty cool, like, spoiler alerts for anyone who somehow has not played the first Final Fantasy. It involved, like, a time loop where, like, the villain would get killed in the present. And then he would go back in time to, with the power of the people who saved him in the present. And then in the past, he would give the people who would save him in the present the power to save him in the present. Yeah.
Just all a big time warp.
Yeah, it basically created a never-ending loop in which he was immortal. Because he would die, be saved, make it so that he was able to be saved again, and yeah. Now we're just gonna get a boss montage. Tornado is another good power for this boss, as you can see. Lots of little hits, you know, being done at once. But there we go, there's the power. High jump. Also, remember when games didn't have like a million people working on them, or million-dollar budgets?
Yeah, and scenes were relatively short.
Yeah. I mean, don't get me wrong, I like the longer games of today, you know? It's more game to enjoy. But sometimes you just can't beat something like this.
Simplicity is always better, I think.
It is.
I think most of the games now are more interested in making money rather than actually developing a really great game. Whereas back then, it was always develop a great game, and we get some money.
Yeah. I mean, hell, Shigeru Miyamoto was like, why the hell are you gonna release a broken piece of shit? Why not just, you know, make it right the first time?
Yeah.
But we shall discuss this discussion in the next video. Farewell, good people of the internet.